Welcome to Cars Retro Reviews. You know, it disgusts me what people will do on the internet just to get attention. Hey people, here, have a look at my dick. With any schmuck, you're not in it for deep character development. You're not in it for some elaborate story. The reason schmups these days are popular is because any idiot with an opposable thumb can enjoy them. They throw you a story most of the time, but it means as much to me as crying after sex. As long as it looks great and the aircraft you're controlling does well, 9 times out of 10, you've got a good game on your hands. You know what? Fuck it. Fuck it in its ass. I'm not going to call them schmups. I refuse to give in and concede that this is a word because those fucking hipster fucking wankers can eat a bag of dicks if they think I'm going to say this monster of a term like it's an official word. Now, having said that, it's only very rarely that shoot-em-ups ever exceed this and add something new or different. There are a few that I can think of that fall under this category, the sort of game that makes you want to keep coming back. But is its enjoyment relative to its ease, or because it's daring to be something new and exciting? This game is a smidge bit different. Ooh, I know it's going to be a little controversial by saying that, but the fact of the matter is, most games which are vertical shooters like this are not on this weird angle this game's on. I remember back when I found out that Leia Section, aka Galactic Attack, had a sequel. I had hard nipples and erotic thoughts that were devious and overtly sexual. I was mentally preparing myself for a game that was potentially as good, if not better. When I woke up from my semen-soaked bed, which by the way is considered illegal in several countries as my semen is more potent than Agent Orange, to the point where I'm pretty sure I came rice pudding the other day, or when I whacked it, you could hear my semen fighting each other out of my dick. The two portion of the title suggests that it's a sequel, and even though it's made by different people, it still hasn't lost anything that made the first one great. Keep it in mind that its original name was Raystorm. It has a new coat of paint, and the graphics are fancier, but your controls are exactly the same as the first game. The one thing the original had that this one carries on through with is the ability to attack on the same level as you, as well as enemies on the ground or in the water. If this was 1997, that would have blown my mind and the semen out of my dick. One thing I mentioned in a previous review was that Media Quest have never done any games of notable mention. While this is mostly true, they did do this game, so I will concede for a moment, but just you wait. The second we get another Media Quest game that eats a lower colon of shit, we'll be getting a mouthful of harshness. This game came out in 1997, and that year IBM's Deep Blue defeats Garry Kasparov in the last game of the rematch, the first time a computer beats a chess world champion. I feel this game could have been better. I don't know how, but since Working Designs did the PS1 conversion, I bet that is a far superior version, as they always do better quality games than most of the other game companies of its time. If you have a look at any Working Design games on the Saturn, they go for phenomenal amounts of money because they're still fun and hold up today. The story in this game starts on Earth in 2219 AD and then goes to the planet Cecilia. Humans invented space travel, which has existed since 2119. Ugh, that is so last century. Humans explored space, and within 100 years, Earth established a 20-colony star federation extending to Orion, with each colony kept under martial law. The colonies then mutinied against the Federation. They took control of the major colony, Cecilia, formed the Cecilia Federation, and defeated Earth's forces after many battles. You gotta go back, recapture and undo what they fucked up, blah 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 blah. So in other words, this game isn't fun. It's a job that you're making me do in the guise of a fun shoot-em-up. I'd complain some more, but I'm having so much fun. Well, okay. This game looks great, sounds great, and plays great. There, I felt I covered everything off. Would I recommend this game? You bet your left nut. It is an essential shoot-em-up for the console, and it doesn't get nearly enough coverage. It's not the greatest shoot-em-up, but it's definitely up there, and being on the Saturn, the shoot-em-up genre gets some stiff competition, which makes this even more impressive. As always, thank you very much for watching. Click on the TV to see the last review, and click on the name underneath the television if you'd like to subscribe.